Each year in the United States, about 13,000 women are diagnosed with cervical cancer, and about 4,000 of those women will die. Here with the risk factors and treatment options are doctors Eric O'Lear and Mario Pineda. They are with Ironwood Cancer and Research Centers. Great to have both of you with us. Thousands of women are dying from this, and you say,
Susan, they don't have to.
They don't have to because they need to take preventative steps now. So what is the cervix?
So the cervix is the part of the uterus that projects into the vagina. It's the birth canal.
So it's the birth canal. It's where we deliver our babies, where we bring life into the world. And so what causes cervical cancer, and what are the risk factors?
So the main risk factor and cause for almost all cervical cancers is the human papillomavirus. It's an endemic infection that most people in the United States will have, but most will clear. It's the persistence of this human papillomavirus, or HPV, mm-hmm. that causes cervix cancer.
All right, so every year women are told, hey, go and get a pap smear, make sure you're being an advocate of your health. What is a pap smear, and is that one of the preventative ways
that we can keep
from getting cervical cancer?
So the pap smear is indicated for all women ages 21 to 65, and then we do the pap test, which checks for the HPV virus as well for older women. These are really important and should be done every 3 to 5 years.
And Dr. O'Lear, some of the treatment options. So a woman hears, yes, you have cervical cancer. What are the treatment options that are available to her at Ironwood?
Sure. So at Ironwood, we have a multidisciplinary team where everyone's under one roof. So the patient really, it's one-stop shopping. They see radiation oncologist, the surgical oncologist, medical oncologist, imaging, nutrition, support services.
It's all there.
The treatment for the cervical cancer, though, is based largely on the stage of the cancer. Mm-hmm. The earlier we catch it, the easier and less invasive the treatment. In fact, Dr. Pineda is one of the pioneers in some really non-invasive approaches for early cervical cancer.
Right, and you were saying, Dr. Pineda, that when we were told it was every year, but women don't necessarily have to get a pap smear that often.
No, you should have a pelvic exam on a regular basis annually, but the pap test actually is dependent on the age and the kind of testing that's done. Every 3 to 5 years.
3 to 5 years. And we've heard a lot about the HPV vaccination for girls as young as preteens. Do you recommend it?
Highly, wholeheartedly.
I do too. In fact, I've given it to my preteen daughters.
Okay, and I was sharing with you, I've got 12-year-olds, girls, twins, and I was really, as a mother, wondering, should I do this? But you're saying it's probably more risky if I don't.
Agreed, and it's available and indicated for both boys and girls, men and women.
And what is the age range for that HPV vaccination?
Really, the goal is to have it before first sexual activity.
Okay, so before sexual activity. I want to go back to cervical cancer. Is it hereditary?
No, it isn't. The number one risk factor for cervix cancer is not having a pap test screening in the last 5 years.
So you're saying that when someone is diagnosed, you're finding that more women haven't had it in roughly, 5 years or so?
And it's actually thought that we could eliminate cervical cancer if worldwide every woman would receive their screening as recommended.
Right, because it is preventable, highly preventable.
Highly preventable.
And how long is the treatment typically?
Again, depends on the stage. Mm-hmm. For a woman with a stage 3 cervical cancer, it's going to be 8 weeks, very intensive radiation and chemotherapy. An early stage 1 cancer might even be able to be treated in the office.
And I know we're talking specifically cervical cancer this morning, but you do a number of treatments for a number of cancers.
We do. So for the Women's Center, we treat all the reproductive and breast cancers, and the Ironwood treats every cancer.
Every cancer, and all in one, under one roof. How does that make the patient, how does that help with recovery?
It's less running around, less waiting for appointments. Often, he'll have a patient that needs to be seen, he'll walk her to my clinic and I'll see her that day.
Wow.
It's an amazing opportunity for patients to get comprehensive cancer care.
Right, and it's a team approach. Thank you so much. Great information, gentlemen.
We
appreciate you. Ironwood Cancer and Research Centers, they have 9 Valley locations for your convenience. If you would like to book an appointment, please call 480-821-2838 or visit ironwoodcrc.com.